Well, hey everybody, it's BugEater64 and here we are again, getting ready to do a flight. Now, originally this was supposed to be an FSEconomy flight, that wasn't, and then we're going to take a look at, well, we're flying the Twin Otter here, but we're going to be looking at X-Plane 11, .35, Bravo 4, and also we're going to look at Prepared3D version 4, and I'll have a little more about that once we get inside. So with that, we're going to be doing this flight that ended up with 440 plus miles. It was supposed to make us about $9,000, and if I was a cussing man, which I am, then I'd be cussing more. But this being a family channel, for the most part, I'll try not to do that. So, with that, let's just get into the airplane, and I'll explain things more as we go along. See you on the inside. Okay, so here we are inside our Twin Otter. And, as you can see, I'm going to be using the GTN 750. In this flight, and we'll get the aircraft ready to go here. Get that out of the way. Okay, so let's get a little power to this aircraft, make sure our controls are all working right. Okay. Mixture levers, all right. Okay. Let's go with the battery power and master switch, engine primers, and our two fuel pumps. And we can go ahead and start the right engine. And it looks like we've got a good engine start on number one. We're on our right side engine. So let's get the left side engine going. This is a pretty neat little turboprop. Perfect aircraft for the islands here in the Bahamas and out in the Keys. Got decent range, carry a good number of passengers, so yeah, perfect for short aircraft, short runways, and even unimproved runways. set our altitude, cruising altitude for about 5,000 feet. Okay. Got our flight plan set up and our GTM. Leaving out of Princess Juliana International. And going to Copa Rojo, Puerto Rico. Figure out what we need to do. Click on the airport so I can get the ATIS information. There we go. Set up here, heat, nav lights. And get our generators reset. Okay, so everything's looking good. Okay, Freeware, Prepared3D, DC-3. Freeware, X-Plane 11. Prepared, DC-3 cockpit. X-Plane 11, Freeware, DC-3 cockpit. Old school. BT-67 out exterior, another Freeware airplane for Prepared. which the sound isn't working for right now. So, okay, Princess Juliana Airport, Freeware for X-Plane. That's Copa Rojo in Puerto Rico, both X-Plane and Prepared3D. Okay, so we're moving down to the end of the runway to get ready for takeoff. It's a bit of a trip, so we're not going to make you sit through the whole thing. Short line here, and we'll get ready to make sure our airplane is ready to go. Okay, everything looking good here. We're not going to need de-icing today. We are in the tropics. Okay, let's go ahead and turn on the landing lights. Yeah, we don't need the primers anymore. Okay. Let's go ahead and move out onto the runway. And as you can see in the upper left-hand corner, our FSEconomy flight has been started. And this is going to be a rolling start. I'm not going to come to a complete stop. Runway 10, let's get her in the air. And rotate. Doesn't take a lot of runway with this airplane. Dive me into the ocean here, autopilot. Run nav. Think now. Good to go there. All right, so we're on our way. Say goodbye to Princess Juliana International. Head for Puerto Rico, 440 plus miles away. Everything looking good. We're climbing at about 1,000 feet a minute. Don't need our landing lights anymore. A little bit. Make sure we stay in the green. And find a cruising speed that's best just for our fuel efficiency. And once we level off, we can get our speed down to about 170. And that'll help us to make good time. Okay, cruising nicely, and I was doing multitasking actually, and we've missed our altitude. We'll go ahead and I'll let it go up to about 8,000 and then we'll level off. No big deal. Another unimportant message. Well, everything's going great. We're in good shape. Everything's performing well. We're on course and speed. Let's go. Okay, well, hope you enjoyed that, and we are about 30 miles, give or take, from the airport, so we're going to get closer and start losing some altitude and get ready for the landing. And Copa Rojo Airport, and this airport, there is nothing there. Even in the real world, there's nothing there. It's a little strip, and there's a parking pad, and that's about it. Change our altitude to about 700 feet. We have started our descent into the area. Right now we're running about 500 feet a minute. I'm going to make an even steeper descent probably 1,000 to 1,500 just to get down. During that little interlude, we flew through quite a bit of rain between our two locations. And we had pretty good headwind, so that's made our flight longer than was originally planned for. We have plenty of fuel, but taking longer than it was supposed to. And we're off the autopilot. I am flying the aircraft. turboprops are just humming right along. Okay, right now we're just over 2,000 feet. Still descending, but very gradually now. We are flying the Twin Otter in X-Plane 11.35 Beta 4. Just to remove any possible confusion as to which sim we were in. At the end of this flight, we'll be doing a test to listen to the sounds between the Freeware DC-3 in the X-Plane and the Freeware DC-3 in Prepared3D. The Prepared3D version for Freeware DC-3 is actually almost like the cockpit's almost identical to the BT-67 turboprop DC-3. It's also Freeware, but it's a very modern cockpit compared to the X-Plane Freeware DC-3, which is very much old school. But it has been updated with a proper autopilot. But we're just going to listen and give you an idea of the sound packages for both the aircraft and their different sims. We do have the airfield in sight. sits right on top of a hill. Get her lined up here for the runway. Quarter flaps. And full flaps. And that floated the airplane. My bad. But let's smooth it out. Not bad. Minus 130 plus feet per minute. Little bump, but not bad at all. We'll take it. Come down to the end of the runway here and pull to our right where the parking pad is. Flaps are up, aircraft is cleaned up. And if you look in the upper left hand, you see the FSEconomy information and it's yellow, so that's bad. So we'll get stopped here and end the flight and see what was bad. Set the parking brake. All right, let's go ahead and end the flight. And no credit, flight has been canceled because we've exceeded our rental time. And I was afraid of that. FSEconomy strikes again. This aircraft had a 3-hour rental. It took me 3 hours and 57 minutes to get here. Alright, so we'll cancel the flight. Okay, so here's the Freeware DC-3 from X-Plane 11. And we're going to run through a quick startup and listen to the engine sounds. So we turn on our fuel. Set propeller RPMs. Crack the throttle on the right engine. Set our mixture. I will go ahead and do both of them. Open them both. Alrighty. So, turn on our main battery power. Turn on our fuel pumps. Magnetos. And no smoking and seat belts. And our beacon, so people know what's going on. Prime the engine to a count of 5. And start her up. Alrighty, so let's get ready to start the left engine. Prime it. Count of 5. And start. Two good engine starts. The engines here. Back to cold and dark. And that's what our Freeware DC-3 sounds like in X-Plane. So now we're going to see what the DC-3, which they actually call it, I think it's a C-117 something. Anyway, but this is in Prepared3D version 4. We're gonna cheat here. I'm gonna let the crew start it up.
Engine 1 starting up.
Oil pressure is coming
up. Starting up.
Oil pressure is coming up.
Engine 1 stabilized.
Engine 2 stabilized.
And this is Princess Juliana Airport, and it is stock out of the box for Prepared3D. So in some ways, Prepared3D, it's autogen sometimes better than what we find in X-Plane. I I have not spent a dime on Prepared3D. Which does work with my air hauler too, so I'll be making a couple flights using that. The flight characteristics of the aircraft, though, I prefer, seem to be more realistic in X-Plane. The aircraft in Prepared fly very well. I can't complain about that. But they don't seem to have the realism that I find with the true world realism that I find in X-Plane. So it's X-Plane 11 is definitely my preferred sim. But Prepared, it's easy to see why it's in my mind number two. And we get our aircraft back to cold and dark. Alright, well, there you have it. A look at FSEconomy, which struck again and did the flight. And I hit some heavy weather and so on, and then the rental on the airplane was only maximum of 3 hours, and it took me 3 hours and 50 minutes to get to my destination, which it shouldn't have, but it did. And so we didn't get credit for a flight. Didn't lose anything, didn't make anything. So I just canceled it, and we'll move forward to the next thing. But we had an interesting look at Freeware aircraft in both X-Plane 11 and also Prepared3D. And I hope you enjoyed that, along with the flight. Like I said, it was a lot of fun. We took off from Princess Juliana International in the islands, and we've landed at Copa Rojo in Puerto Rico. So it was fun. I enjoyed the flight. The Twin Otter operated perfectly, and I've got no complaints whatsoever with that. And it was pilot air for the reason it's not getting credit for FSEconomy. But that's all part of the learning curve. But I do hope you enjoyed the flight, enjoyed the information. Hope you found it hopeful. For me, primarily, X-Plane and Prepared3D are, in my estimation at this time, the two very best civilian-type aircraft simulators. For military aircraft, it's DCS world, hands down. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. They built it for military aircraft, and by golly, that's what it's great at. So, hope you enjoyed the video, and until next time, this is BugEater64, wishing you all a great weekend, and as always, safe flying.